beautiful angels, this is Miss Dixie from Magic Wands Tarot, and this is your what is coming next chance reading. Yes, friends, this is for the week of 15 to the 22nd of September, friends, and this is not a pick a card reading. This is a collective reading, friends, and there will be charms in this reading at the end of this reading. Why I'm doing it like this, because I have guests at home today and I'm running short of time, but I wanted to cover because many of you requested the weekly reading, so here it is. And also the themes are merging, friends, because every week, you know, instead of three piles, you know, there are collective themes coming into the week. So let's see how this week will be for you. And we'll look into the detailed reading for it, and I'll shuffle for you live, so that will also be there for all of you asking for live shuffling on the screen. Let's see, we'll also be pulling romance angels messages, so let's see how this week will be. So what's happening astrologically? So friends, okay, before we start, do subscribe Magic Wands Tarot, friends, do subscribe, because we continue to bring you new readings every day. Subscribe, like and share, it keeps me motivated. Thank you so much if you have already subscribed. Many angel blessings, friends. Do like this video if you want to see more of these collective readings. Please do like this video and live, because I get to do live shuffling in collective readings, because in pick a card readings they get very long, friends, for me, especially with guests at home. It's too much work, and that's not it's too much for me personally, so I'm trying to, you know, keep everything balanced. So I know you are very supportive, thank you so much. So what's happening astrologically this week? Venus will be coming into Leo. That will bring passions, that will also make you feel very sexy, very passionate. And there is a new moon in Virgo. Congratulations, Virgos. And on the new moon, you can also make some new wishes, new dreams. It is on the 17th. And at the end of this week, around the 21st and 22nd, there is the equinox. And happy birthdays, Libra. Yes, friends, it's a birthday time for our Libras. So let's see. What's coming next in this week for you? This is a charms reading. Wait for the charms at the end. What's going to happen in the week of 15 to 22nd? Okay. Ten of Cups, Page of Swords. How this week will be? We'll look into details, so don't worry about it, friends. The Judgment in Reverse. Wow, that's interesting. I will keep it in reverse. What's going to happen? What's coming next in the week? Wow, soulmate relationships. Interesting. What's going to happen this week? What's coming next from 15 to 22nd for all of us? Two of Swords. Hanged Man. I hope you can see the cards. I guess that's better. What else? What else is going to happen? Okay, the Nine of Cups and the Four of Wands. Interesting, friends, interesting. I do see some of you are waiting for informations and messages regarding especially love and education. I definitely feel you are waiting for some sort of a message this week, friends. All of us, or some of us, are waiting for messages or news regarding love or regarding your work or education. Definitely, I feel you are waiting for some news, and I have to tell you, some good news is coming to you in this week or at the end of this week. Absolutely, something good will happen, or some good news is going to come your way. I do feel in love, you may be feeling a little, you know, disappointed this week, or you are already feeling like someone is judging you, or, you know, someone was not being honest or fair to you, or someone hurted you. You start this week with that energy, you know, like some things are not going right. You feel like life is unfair. Why? You have done your work, but life is not giving you your reward, especially in love. You feel like, why is this happening? Why you are not getting your rewards? Where is it? You have worked hard. You are questioning universe. You are questioning life. You are questioning destiny. I do feel, friends, you will find some support from your family or some friends this week. You will, I think some of you are having some issues with your family not getting along well, but you will find some support from a family or from some cousins or common friends. Definitely, you will find some support or happy times with your family. But with love, you are questioning. In this week, your questions are big. You are questioning why life is not giving you your rewards. You have worked hard, but love is not coming. That marriage is not happening. Why? Because there is a soulmate that's destined for you. There is something that's destined for you, and it is going to happen. It is going to happen. There is this soulmate connection coming for you. There is a strong love connection. Let me just clarify, what is the Two of Swords about? Ooh, Empress coming into your power. The Hanged Man. Ooh, money is coming your way, friends, this week. Congratulations. I knew some of you were waiting for money. I knew it. You are like worried about money, career or businesses. Yes, it's going to be resolved, especially if you are a restaurant owner or something like that. You are really worried. Business owners. Let me know. I'll be happy to order from you, you know. Let me know if your business is affected because of the world situation. Let us know. We'll be happy to help you. All right. I do feel that some of you are not feeling happy in your love situation. You feel someone is judging you. You feel someone is not understanding you. Or you are alone and single and you feel life is unfair. Life is hard. Life is not giving you what you want. But I feel a soulmate relationship is destined for you. This person, this soulmate connection is meant for you. But it will happen when you step out of this confusion. You need to connect with your power this week, friends. You need to connect with your inner goddess or God energy. You need to focus on yourself this week, friends. It's very important. And why? Because, you know, God is guiding you to take care of your body, your health, your mental health, your education, your career. Make yourself a priority. Make yourself a priority this week. And I know I say this, this is a repeating theme. That's why I did this a common reading. Because in last week also this came in some of the piles. But this is very strong this week. I do feel, friends, maybe some loved one or some family member is not valuing you. And you are doubting your value. But don't do that, friends. Connect with your power. If you want to start some new goal, some new hobby, or if you want to lose weight or turn into, like, you know, expand your family, don't doubt yourself. Trust your intuition. Do not second guess your decisions this week, friends. You are powerful. You are this emperor or this empress. If you have taken a decision in the past, you may think about it this week. Why you took this decision? Were you right? Were you right in cutting some people off? You know, were you right in leaving a job? You're thinking about the past. Past is on your mind. But remember, you are this present. You are becoming this queen or the king. And this week, focus on yourself. Focus on your money, your hobbies, your goals, your health. I also see some of you will become more attached to your mother or your mother-in-law, or if you are a female, you will feel the need to love somebody or protect them like a mother, you know. I would suggest that you should do it with yourself, or, you know, maybe your career is your baby. You want that baby. You want that baby, you know, like something is your baby. Maybe it is this soulmate. Maybe you want your own children. If you are married, I would say fertility is very high this week. So go for it. Fertility is very high. Creativity, very high. You may also feel very emotional this week, friends. So stay a little patient, because I would say take your time making any decisions. Any quick decisions or judgments or views may not work this week. Because Venus is in Leo, so it makes us very passionate, you know. It makes us very passionate. But Sun is in Virgo. So that makes us very cautious also. So, you know, you have to analyze your decisions, but you want to also, Leo is like, I want to be impulsive. So you have to wait. Take your time. Don't rush this week. Also, keep working on your goals. I see you working. The more you work on your goals, on your dreams, on your hobbies, it will bring you success. Absolutely. Whether it is your marriage, whether it is your love life, whether it is your education, keep working on it. Don't make rash decisions, please. Because good news is coming, friends. Nine of Cups of Happiness. Some good news is going to come regarding money, regarding your job, regarding your finances. If you are giving some finance exams or some interviews, some exams, you can expect positive results. Most of you can. I do see some of you will graduate or pass out of colleges with good results. Some of you may join postgraduate courses this week, or you will, you know, start the application, and you might know that you will hear that you are selected, or you can apply, or you are eligible for it. I do see some sort of a celebration coming at around the equinox, some past person coming back, and things in your love life returning back to normal. Yes, friends, happiness coming, some celebrations coming. I also feel there is a wedding anniversary or birthdays or something at the end of this week for you. Maybe it is yours or is someone in the family. Who are the people that are important to you this week? Aquarius, Libra, Gemini person is important. Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus person is important to you this week. I also feel an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius person is important to you this week. And you will feel very powerful this week. You may start the week with a little doubt, with the focus on your past, like why someone hurted you, why they did that, why your family is not supporting. But you will shift very quickly into this emperor or this empress. So let's see what else will happen in your week. Let's see what will be the main block for you this week, and the main challenge and the main blessing. Wow. The main challenge is Ace of Pentacles. You want a new start in your work. You want work, money, money, money. Oh God, I wanna, you know, it's like you want your money. You want success. Your focus is on career. Your focus is on money. Your focus is on self-worth. This is the challenge for you. Why? Let's see. You want a new start. Maybe it's not coming for you. Why is it a challenge, angels? Knight of Rods, yes, you are working. This is the time for you to work. Get ready. I feel like, you know, this, whether you, I think some of you are looking for a job, or waiting for travel, or moving into a new house, like you have shifted a house, or you want to leave a house, but the new house is not there, you can't find it, or you are looking for a job, but it's not yet appeared to you, it has not come into your life. Keep working, don't get disheartened, it's very close. Keep your eyes on the goal. Yes, friends, it's coming into a challenge because it's very near you. This money, this success, this whatever you're waiting for or working for, it is coming. But don't give up, nana. So what's the main challenge for this week for our friends, our viewers? See, communications, a lot of communications. I see you, you know, talking a lot, getting socially very active, and sending a lots of emails coming, messages coming. You may also be binge watching, so I think that can also become a problem, especially if you have exams or if you have other work assignments to complete, or you have to work, focus on your work, but you want to binge watch. So friends, you know, maybe you are binge watching our channel. Yeah, Eight of Cups. You are actually, you know, your past is also stopping you. That's also a challenge, friends. See, your past is stopping you. Look at this. You will be thinking about your past. Maybe someone from the past will try to message you, or you might see something on their social media, or you have to end something this week, or you have ended something in the past few weeks, but you will think about it. So it is a challenge for you to come out of it and focus on things which are necessary for you now. So what's the blessing coming for you? Let's see that. Blessings coming this week. Now, see, friends, it's all coming out positive. So, I don't cherry pick my cards. I don't have that much time, friends. So, your blessings are a breakthrough is coming. This clarity is coming. Information is coming. News is coming. Official confirmations are coming. Something is bothering you. Something is not clear to you. You have like choices right now. You're confused. You have some confusion, like maybe where your life is going, you don't know. Maybe there is nothing new or exciting happening. You don't feel directed, you don't direction, you don't feel excited, you don't feel a passion about your life. Or you are waiting for news, it's not yet come. But it's coming, friends, that's the blessing. You will have more than one choice. I feel some of you are like you have no options now. All your options are closed. Because of the world situation or because nothing is working, everything is closed. Your blessings are new options coming to you and one of the options actually materializing for you. Yes, friends. Let's see what else. What blessings are coming for this week for our viewers? Ooh, the Six of Pentacles, your karmic rewards. 10 of Wands, 4 of Wands. Yes, you are working very hard. Your hard work will be repaid. Look at this. All your hard work, your patience, it is going to return back to you. These endings are going to, you know, the endings, you know, something has ended, but you will understand why it happened. This week, you will understand why it happened. Your karmic rewards are coming. Money is coming. Whatever you have been patient about, you will get the reward of it, and also you will get some time to rest. I see it is a busy week for you, but you will get some time to rest and relax this week and, you know, enjoy this week also. And I definitely feel if someone has hurted you, you will see that, you know, it's like, you know, someone from a long distance wants to message you. Someone who is, I see someone is keeping an eye on you. They want to message you. But I feel like the same thing is going to happen to them. If they hurted you, they will also be hurt. And you will get the, it's not a good thing to say that you will see them hurt or something. But it is like justice being done for you, friends. Yes. It is like this clear cut justice being done for you with clarity. And you will be able to see it. Let's see what else. Let's see some oracle messages for you. Then we're gonna look into what's the advice for you. So how this week will be from the 5th. Ooh, deceit number 25. Yeah, I do feel someone is keeping a close eye on you, especially maybe at your work, maybe, you know, your ex-lover, ex-husband, wife, twin flame. Someone is keeping a close eye on you. Number 25 is important. I do feel, friends, be careful because Mercury will be going retrograde after this week or maybe around this week. So I would suggest you to stay careful about communications, money, and your, you know, phones, and especially money. If someone is asking you, you know, for bank details or anything, or don't go for it, friends. It can be, you need to stay careful. You know, don't double check everything, friends. Trust me, please double check everything. It has flew, this card just jumped out. So please double check everything. All tied up, number 23. Yes, someone is lying to you, you know. Someone is hiding their true feelings. Someone is not telling you how much they love you. And they are keeping you stuck. But clarity will come in that situation. Adjacent possibilities, yes, new possibilities are coming. And look at this, 23, 24, 25. Wow, this is 23, 24, 25 number cards. This is interesting. So new possibilities are coming your way, friends. Keep your eye open. Don't focus too much on the past. Anything else for this week for our viewers? What will happen? We will look at the charms, so don't worry. Oh, community, yes, you are going to find some new friends, new friendships, new hobbies, new career goals. I think there are people who will help you out from your community, from people around you, live, neighbors. I think you need to explore a little on social media also, talk a little. So if you talk, you will find many people are there which are in similar situations like you and they can help you. Sixth chakra, Archangel Metatron. Wow. A lot of important messages are coming, not just about your love life or career, but also about your spiritual development and your life path, friends. So stay very, very clear and notice all the signs which are coming. I do feel if you are in a twin flame relationship, you will feel a lot of their emotions, or something will get clear in that relationship. Any advice for you for this week? Any advice? Positive energy. Friends, yes, this is the time to surround yourself with positive people and situations and do not go to negativity. Avoid negativity. Look at this. This is time for you to find some new friends or make some new friends. And how can you do that? You start by being very positive yourself and start by talking something, you know, talking to people. Go out and talk. Maybe you can talk here at our channel or maybe on social media, WhatsApp, Instagram. There are lots of mediums. Let's see what else is the advice. Positive energy is coming, friends. Don't worry about it. Self-employment. Yes, some of you, if you are not able to find a job, you can make your own job. Yes, you are strong. Have faith. Your prayers are being answered. Your prayers are manifesting. Remain positive. Follow your guidance. Yes, friends. Signs are going to guide you, friends. Keep your eyes open and have faith. Things are going to shift. If you are feeling depressed and anxious, don't lose hope. Don't lose hope. See, I'm working so hard, so don't lose hope. If I'm here, then I'm sure, if we all are here as Magic Wands Tarot friends, I'm sure you have lots of friends here. We all are with you, so don't fear. Don't be alone. We are with you. So let's take some lovey-dovey messages for this week. For this week, for our viewers. Okay, this one I come. Pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Oh my God, friends. Wow. Oh my God. I think there is a person who is watching you, keeping an eye on you. You don't trust that person, not at all. I do feel someone new can also come into your life, but you have to keep your eyes open because you have the deceit, the red flags. Anything else? Worth waiting for. Divine timing is at work in your love life. Yes, friends. If love, your focus is mostly on your life, your career this week, and on understanding your past situation or a lover, but keep waiting. Divine timing is at work. Things are going to shift in your love life, so don't give up. So let's see what else. Your charms. Let's see, look at your charms. Let's leave the cards here only. I'm gonna put them aside a little so we can have some space. Let's see, for this week of 15th to 22nd of September, how this week will be for our viewers collectively. Wow. So your letters are C, X, an X is coming back this week, friends, or is on your mind, or you are on their mind. See, there is an X and there is new. Something new is also coming. Maybe they will want to message you in a new way, return back to you in a new way, or maybe a new lover is coming. I don't know. Can you make another word out of it? I don't know. ENT, maybe some doctors. You might need to see a doctor, or some health issues might come up, like, you know, some allergies or something. So drink some water, friends. And take care. I do see some allergy. Maybe, you know, you are sneezing or something. I see some allergies. There is this doctor's thing. You could be dealing with a doctor this week, or someone who is a Reiki physician, healer. You could also be learning these things because you have the self-employment. So you could be learning new things like Reiki, healing, astrology, tarot cards. Or maybe you are learning in about, you know, about some natural healing, naturopathy, all those things, friends. And the dark horse, yes, you are very strong. Don't worry. Trust in your luck. Have faith. Have faith. Ship, messages from long distance, news from long distance, other countries are important. There is also this blue card. This is about, you know, sixth chakra. Keep your eyes open, look at the signs. The signs, the universe is guiding you, so keep your eyes open. And here is the robin. I know some people will start correcting me whenever I pull this charm, because it's for me it's a Spider-Man, but everyone is like, nope, that's not a Spider-Man. But I'll say it's a Spidey. Okay, so your superhero is coming. I do feel you are, our viewers are a superhero. So don't worry, friends. Believe in your strength. Wow. You have this. You are trying to fix something, friends. Fix your career. Fix your love life. Yes, you are in the mode to fix things, you know. You are like, I want to have my own career, my own business. I will fix things. I will not give up. I also feel, friends, because the Mercury is about to go retrograde, stay careful. It's like someone can fall down, or, you know, like you can trip or bump into things, like, you know, just your bump into things, you know. So stay careful, friends, stay careful, because you have twice the doctor's thing. So stay careful. You also have the pink hat. Someone wants to offer their love to you or some compliments to you. There is the headphones. I do see you will be listening to a lot of music, a lot of messages online. I also see some of you could be starting work online with your setup and everything. And maybe you could be dealing with a musician, an artist this week. The red flower. You are a flower. Things are blossoming, opening for you. You also have the yellow car. Stay positive. Positive energy. Focus on the good things in life. The lion. Yes, you are very strong. Your star is about to shine. There is this leaf. Oh, wait. Oh, this is not a leaf. My God. Ooh, this is an angel wing, friends. So yes, you are guided. Have faith. You are protected. And there is this mini leaf here. It is like, let go of the past. Don't bother about it. Some happy celebrations are coming. This three of hearts. This is happiness, celebrations, friendships. Fated. Yes, you are destined for success. You are destined for your, you know, you are destined to have money in your career. Prince of Cups, a new romance. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, it's destined. It's coming for you. Six of Cups, it is a soulmate of yours. You may have known this person. Moon energy. Yes, this person is romantic. This relationship is going in cycles. So we had the card, worth waiting for, remember? September, wow. September is going important for you. We are in September, so something is going to shift. Two of Cups, yes. Love is coming your way, friends. Happy unions are coming. Ace of Coins, a new start in your job. This is going to be a busy week for you. Yellow, again yellow. Think positive. UK is important, friends. UK is important. Britain, UK, USA are important. Whew. So that's it for now, friends. If you enjoyed this new sort of readings, friends, please do subscribe Magic Wens Tarot, like and share. Let me know in the comment section, do you enjoyed this collective reading? Because, friends, I need your reviews. And if you notice, from the last 1 week, I have done some amazingly interesting readings and very different readings. So let me know if you enjoyed this, and shall I continue this? Let me know that in the future, because I think sometimes collective energies are also amazing, because we are growing as a community, you know. And also this year is a very special year, so group messages are what we need sometimes, you know, like group healing, like, you know, group meetings. So yes, this was a GD session, group meeting session. So make sure to subscribe Magic Wens Tarot. Join us on Instagram. And this is Mystic C. Singh. Bye bye.